Welcome back to the Sage Audio Channel. Today we'll list our picks for the top 7 quick mastering tips. We'll go into detail about these tips, as well as listen to examples of some of them, so stick around if you need a little help with your mastering. But first, if you're an artist, engineer, or producer, and you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample of it. All you have to do is set up an account, upload this song, and we can do the rest. So number 7 is use 2 limiters and split the processing between them. Now, typically engineers stick to 1 limiter. However, using 2 limiters in a series can help alleviate the pressure that would be put on one of them. Now, if you find that you're using heavy limiting and you notice that the timbre of your master is changing drastically because of it, try 2 limiters back to back. By splitting the limiting across the 2 of them, you'll notice less of a timbre change and less distortion than if you used just 1. Now, this is also a great technique even if you aren't using significant limiting. If you use different limiters with unique timbres, you can achieve tones that you otherwise wouldn't have been able to. For example, I like to combine the Weiss DS1 Mark III with the FabFilter Pro L2 to achieve a distinctive sound. Let's take a listen to it. Number 6, use a high pass filter on your side image. Now, this is one technique that I use a lot and introduce into just about every master and tutorial that I make. Now, it may not be for everybody and it definitely has its limitations, but making the side images low frequency range mono is almost always a good idea. Doing this is pretty simple. Use an equalizer with mid-side capabilities. On the side image, use a high pass filter and cut out roughly up to 130 Hz. Now, this means that all frequencies below 130 Hz are now mono. So your bass and your kick are now primarily mono, meaning that your master will sound more driving and focused. Additionally, if you're finding that your master is sounding a little muddy, this is a great first step to take. Try it out for yourself and let us know if it makes a difference on one of your mixes or masters. Let's take a listen to it. Number 5, sandwich a multi-band expander between 2 limiters. This is a new technique that I've been trying, and it came about after a friend asked me to remaster an already mastered track. I noticed that if I expanded the already limited master and then followed it with another limiter, I could achieve a very aggressive and pop-centric sound. To translate this into a typical mastering session, I would use 1 limiter to control some of the dynamics and increase the volume, then follow that limiter with a multi-band expander and boost the kick, mid-range vocal, and some of the high frequencies. After I compensate for any overs or clipping by adjusting the outputs of these plugins, I follow the multiband expander with another limiter and then very subtly increase the gain. Now what this does is heavily compress the signal, then make what's compressed more dynamic, and then adds just a little bit more loudness with the last limiter. This technique is a little unorthodox, and it doesn't work for every genre, but if you're trying to achieve an aggressive sound that maintains its dynamics, try this one out. Let's take a listen to it. Number 4, try EQ matching your master to another for comparison. Now we've all heard of using a reference track, but we can take this a step further by matching our master's EQ to that of another great sounding master. Granted, this effect may be too extreme to keep, but it'll help us understand what's different about our masters and the ones that we thoroughly enjoy. A great plugin for this is the FabFilter Pro Q3, which allows us to match the frequency response of two tracks using some sidechaining and the EQ match function. First, try to make sure that the gain of the two masters is relatively the same. You'll most likely use clip gain to reduce the gain of your reference master. Then find a segment of the reference that is very similar to the section of your master. Then match the two segments. After you delete or tame some of the more extreme bands, take a listen to your master and see how it compares. Did the sound improve, did it not? If it improved significantly, it might be best to go back and address some issues in the mix or with your mastering chain. Number 3, use parallel compression with low-level compression. Parallel compression is great, but what's better is parallel compression followed by low-level compression. In short, you use an auxiliary send to separate your signal into two. Then you heavily compress the auxiliary send and lower the channel fader to blend the effect in with your original signal. Now if we add a low-level compressor on the auxiliary channel, we can increase the details and nuance of the already compressed signal. By doing this and then subtly blending the effect back in with your original signal, we can create a truly impressive and full sound. Now keep in mind that only a little bit of the parallel compressed signal should be reintroduced into your master. Let's take a listen to it. Number 2, set a quicker limiter release time for a transparent sound. The release time of a limiter is one of its most important functions. It has the ability to both drastically improve or degrade the quality of your master. Set a quicker release time if you want a more transparent sound. Set a slower release time if you want a smoother, more relaxed sound. A quicker release is best for pop and rap, whereas a slower one is probably better for funk and soul. Now keep in mind that since you're affecting the entire stereo signal, what you do has a huge impact on the timbre. Additionally, don't make your release time quicker than about 30 milliseconds, since this is going to cause noticeable and unpleasant distortion. Let's take a listen to it. Last up at number one, we have Listen to Your Master with Multiple Devices. It never hurts to monitor your master on multiple sources. This is why studios have multiple pairs of speakers set up. You want to understand how your music sounds on multiple playback systems before sending it out. Once you understand this, you know what compromises need to be made. You'll need to find a balance between what sounds good on your monitors, what sounds good in a car, what sounds good over earbuds, and so on. Ideally, we could make masters for each set of speakers, but this is nearly impossible. With that said, try to monitor your master on multiple speakers and create the best sound possible. So, these are our picks for the top 7 quick mastering tips, but what do you think? Is there a trick that you use, but we didn't mention it here? Let us know in the comment section below. Also, if you're an artist or an engineer, send us one of your mixes at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample. All you have to do is set up an account, upload the song, and we do the rest. But thank you so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like and share this video with your friends. This way we know if you'd like to see more videos like this one. Also, you can subscribe to the channel. We release new videos every week, and subscribing is the best way to stay up to date. There's a comment section where you can leave your thoughts on this video or make a suggestion for a future video. And again, if you're an artist or an engineer and you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.